Biff's Gaming Videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Swimmers and my guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from Biff Sun.
Fun.
This is Buck Rogers' Planet of Zoom. This is an arcade port, which was kind of revolutionary for the time because it was in 3D. You had a periscope that you'd look through like a viewer, and then you'd have an LCD shutters, and it would establish like a 3D effect. The object is, you're sitting there flying over the planet of Zoom. I guess everything's zooming towards you, like in a 3D kind of thing. And you're shooting at everything. And you're trying to get through basically like sort of like an obstacle course. You know, you have to stay in between these two bars, and bad guys are coming at you and are shooting at you and so forth. And the game gets progressively tougher and tougher and tougher. More bad guys, different types of bad guys, they start firing at you and so forth. And once you get to so many of these towards the end, the screen starts flashing and you go to a new one. And then after you do several of them, then you basically have to go against the motherships. And that's it. And you just keep going and going and going and going and going. Now, the only thing about Buck Rogers in this is that there's nothing with Buck Rogers in this. They basically took the name and I guess they licensed it out, so now it's called Buck Rogers. Buck Rogers had several TV shows going back a long, long, long time, so it's not really based off of, you know, the Jill Gerard one with Tweety going around. And I'm sure Jill Gerard, even today, walks around and people, like, do that to him in his back. He's like, you know, what's that? People are going, Tweety. So it's more of a Buck Rogers-style universe. Of course, there was the movie, you know, and there was a whole Buck Rogers universe going on, and it was a TV show for a while, and none of these have anything to do with each other. They just basically took the name and made a video game out of it. You look at the top, you have so much fuel to finish what you're doing, you have so many ships and so forth, and so it's kind of a repetitive kind of game. The 5200 version actually looks pretty decent as far as a 3D type game, but it was never that fun in the arcade to begin with, and it's definitely not fun in the home version. And if you see here, you're just shooting at these guys, you know, big whoop, you know, it's like any other space thing, but it is sort of like in 3D-ish, first person perspective. Not like the arcade, which is like actually 3D. It kind of gives you the feel of a 3D. Some people really like this game, particularly the arcade version. I just don't see it. I never really liked in the arcade. I thought it was kind of a neat kind of trick, but the 3D, you know, wears off really fast. And then you take a look at it at home, it's like, okay, it looks all right, but the gameplay isn't there. It's just not a fun game. You're just shooting and shooting and shooting, and that's pretty much it. You know, it's game over, man. Game over. I'm going to give this game a C. There's nothing really special about it. I mean, they did what they could with the port. I mean, the port looks fine. It's just the actual game was never really good in the arcade, my opinion. It was average in the arcade, and the 5200 is average. But if you like the arcade version, you're like this. It's just, it's an average game to begin with. A C.